Have you ever wondered how DJs get from one genre to a totally different genre? Or how to mix throughout your entire music library up and down drastic BPM changes? My name's Jamie Hartley here at Crossfader, and I'm here to help you learn three very easy ways to transition from one genre of music to another genre of music. These three techniques can be applied to nearly any DJ setup. So no matter what equipment or software you've got sat in front of you at home, you should be able to follow along with these tutorials and perform very similar styles of mixes. These mixes will help you play to a very wide range of crowds and keep any crowd happy, because you're going to be able to play any genre of music with ease and also make it sound nice and clean. After you've watched the three different transitions at the end of the video, please comment below which one was your favorite, using either transition 1, 2, or 3. And also remember to like, comment, share, subscribe, do all of that good stuff to help us keep making more videos and tutorials just like this one. So let's start with the easiest way to transition from one genre to a different genre. I've got two songs here, one at 128 BPM and one at 100 BPM. Now, you would never try and mix those two songs at their original BPM over the top of one another, because the beats would clash and they wouldn't stay in time. However, what you can start to do is listen to your music and use the music to your advantage. So a lot of house, future house, EDM styles of music will have big breakdowns, big build-ups, and big drops. Now, the big breakdowns in the music you can use to your advantage to then play something else, because if a song breaks down to almost nothing, it leaves gap and some room in the mix to then play the next song. So let's have a listen to this example I've got. This is Third Party, Red Hot Chili Peppers remix of Other Side. If I skip into the song towards this second breakdown here and have a listen. And you'll hear this breakdown now cuts down to pretty much silence. Now, this is a perfect opportunity for you to switch up the genre of music, because the beats aren't going to clash if you were to hit play on the opposite side. Like I said, this is the easiest way to transition between genres, is to use the song itself and the spaces within it. I'm going to leave everything, like the EQs, all at their original position. I'm going to leave the BPMs at their original BPM. Then all I'm going to do is count 1, 2, 3, 4 before pressing play, just to allow a bit of room after it's broken down before the next track starts playing. Don't forget to either pause the original song or kill the fader so that it doesn't come back in again. Let's have a listen to how that sounds. One, two, three, four. Now, even though this sounds like one song is stopping and another song is just starting, because you've used the track itself rather than just cut it out at some random point, you've used the natural track itself, the crowd won't be caught out too much, because they're expecting the track to break down, but instead of the breakdown then building up again, you're just playing the next song. We've gone into there, Skrillex, The Reason, and this is a nice song to start with because it doesn't start too heavy and it's got this nice lead in. Again, picking the right songs when you do these transitions are going to be key in making it sound smooth. You don't want to play a song that is all guns blazing, really loud and really intense right from the start. You want something that's going to build up and not catch the crowd out too much. In this next transition, we're going to look at how to use some basic effects that you can find on nearly all DJ equipment to actually transition from one song to another, especially when you don't have the luxury of a big breakdown like in the last transition. So we're going to follow on using the Skrillex track, The Reason, and go into an indie track, Sex on Fire by Kings of Leon. Totally different genres, totally different BPMs. So the first thing is to think about the structure of your music. If I just scroll further into The Reason, here in the main drop, we can then set up our echo, and at the end of the main section of the song, we can apply an echo, kill the fader down, and just press play on the next side. Now, first of all, you want to look at the waveform and listen to the music and think, where is the end of this section? So this is the last bar, you would call it, of a phrase.
So before that next breakdown comes in, I'm going to apply the echo over that last bar. First of all, to set up the echo on this piece of equipment, for example, I've got the echo selected. I'm choosing channel 2. And then I'm going to set the beat fraction on one whole beat. This means it will echo to the same time of the music. You can play around with this and test out different lengths, but one beat is a good way to echo out. Now, let's have a listen how it would sound if we applied the echo over the end section of this main part of the song. I'm going to turn the echo on and start bringing the level up now. And by killing the fader, you create this nice echo out. Now you want to make sure you even kill the fader in time. So you can count along to the music, and then what I would say is on the second or third beat, kill the fader, and then when it comes back to number one, press play on this side. So let's have a listen to what I mean by that and count along together. We could count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, kill, 4, and 1. Into the next song. Let's do that one more time. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two. Again. This cleans up that transition from one genre to a totally different genre just by using the echo and creating your own echo out. Don't just do it randomly, think about your phrasing in the music, and when a section comes toward the end, you can use the echo out on the last bar before pressing play as if that's the start of the next song and the next phrase. Just to show how this will work with another song, we're going to go from Sex on Fire into Hit Yo Dance, which is an R&B tune. If you have a listen. This one is 93 BPM, Sex on Fire is 153 BPM, again, totally different. This time, I'm going to do it the opposite way around, so I need to switch my echo onto channel 1. I've got a hot cue set towards the end, just so I can skip to the end and show you how it would sound going from the Sex on Fire song to a hip-hop song. Counting, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then pressing play. You'll notice that time, because there was a lot going on with Sex on Fire, I counted an extra 4 beats worth of echo before pressing play. I'll do that one more time just so you can hear it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And that sounds really nice and clean. For the third transition technique, we're going to be applying a few more things. It's still relatively easy, but there's a few more things going on. So we're going to break it down into steps. On most pieces of DJ equipment, you can find something called a tempo range or a tempo width adjust. Now on this Pioneer DDJ-200, it's a shift control. So you can see it's highlighted here with the tempo range in the gray box. So by holding shift, I can press this beat sync button and it will toggle through different tempo ranges. Now on the screen, we can see here that if I go up and down, it'll only go 6% faster or 6% slower. If I toggle this, it'll then change to plus or minus 10% faster or 10% slower. Do it again, 16% faster, 16% slower. And you'll notice now we're starting to reach much wider BPM values. One more time, and it goes to wide, which means we can pretty much double the speed and go down to nothing. So we've got 100% range that we can work with, and this means that we can stretch this song to pretty much any BPM value we want. So here we've got a housey song, or it's actually quite a bassy song, up at 134 BPM. And on the opposite side, we've got a remix of The Game, How We Do, at 105 BPM at its original speed. So what we're going to do is actually take the audience, take the crowd, the listener, down to this new BPM range. So what we can do is find a section of the song that we think will sound nice looped, and then take that loop and manually make it slower while the track's playing. Now the trick here is to not do it too fast and suddenly jump to the wrong BPM, and also not take too long so the crowd are wondering what's going on. So we've got to find this fine line where we can even count along and start making our way down to 105 BPM. Now it might be tricky to get it exact, so this might take a bit of practice, and you may find you have to nudge the track slightly just to improve on the timing after you set off the next song. So let's have a look at how this works. First of all, get used to your tempo adjust. Get used to what it feels like to go from 134 BPM down to 105 BPM and what that movement is. It's not actually that far on the tempo adjust when it's in the wide mode. So we can get down to pretty much bang on 105. Now let's try it in the mix. So later on in the song, I'm going to go into the breakdown and then loop a section of the breakdown in my loop pad mode, and then take that loop and slow it down manually now that I've got prepared on my tempo adjust. We're getting towards the breakdown now. Always listen to the music and think what sounds nice as a I'm going to choose a 4-beat loop, for example. So somewhere here. So that sounds quite nice. We can then slow it down. Get it as close as you can. You might struggle to get it bang on. A little nudge to correct any timing and then carry on with your mix. To improve the sound, I'm going to just drop the frequency, the filter, sorry, before fully mixing. Now the reason why I set a loop is because I don't want the track to then build back up again and drop back in at this much slower speed. It holds it where it is and gives you that time to then make the transition. Now you'll notice that I was having to play around quite a bit with the tempo adjust to try and get it exact. So what you could do is just knock the other track in time by getting it somewhere near and then just hitting the sync button on the opposite side just to make sure that the BPMs are locked, especially as a beginner DJ. So let's do that one more time, undo the loop, reset all of our parameters. I'm getting ready to set the loop. Start slowing it down. So if I hit sync on the other side now, it'll lock the BPMs and get ready to press play. Use that filter out. And kill the fader at the end of the mix. So like I said, there is a bit more going on here. It's a little bit more advanced because we're using a few different features at the same time and then physically mixing the two songs together. You need to get confident at pressing play on time and making sure you can nudge a track gently just to knock it in time if you press play slightly wrong. But then that's where we can basically mix almost anything into anything by using one of these three different techniques. Some of the techniques will sound better in certain instances and with certain tracks over others. So pick the one that will work best for you in your set and the crowd that you're playing to.
And there we have it, three easy ways that you can mix from one genre to a totally different genre. Now I hope you can take these transitions and use them in your next DJ set to keep that crowd on their toes and to keep the entire crowd happy. Remember to comment below which of the three were your favorite. And if you want to learn some more advanced transition techniques and want to take these skills further, then click the link where you can watch a free DJ lesson from our DJ Transitions course. This course is full of beginner to advanced techniques on how to mix between totally different genres, play mashup sets, and be a real all-round DJ. In the course, you'll learn things like finger drumming techniques, how to mix from trap to drum and bass, to hip hop, to house, to rock music. You'll learn advanced beat gridding and how to use acapellas to switch out between different genres. It's full of exciting techniques to make your sets unique and stand out. Like I said, click the link, to watch a free lesson that's more advanced than these transition techniques from that course. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to comment below which was your favorite, and I'll see you in another tutorial very soon.